about to lose your job because you are detaining me for nothing. You are about to lose your job. You are about to lose your job. Get this dance. You about to lose your job because you are detaining me for nothing. You about to lose your job. You about to lose your job. Get this dance. You about to lose your job because you are detaining me for nothing. You about to lose your job. You about to lose your job. Get this dance. You about to lose your job because you are detaining me.
The Bible is not a one-time decision. It's not a one-time act. It's a one-time decision. It's not a one-time act. It's something that goes on and on and on. The Bible is not a one-time decision. It's not a one-time act. It's something that goes on and on and on. The Bible is not a one-time decision. It's not a
was not a On these people who are particular in my life have made a difference. A view into what Detroit is about. I mean, you have like this great tradition of gospel music, also, you know, very staunch bebop tradition. I understand there's a really strong hip-hop thing going on there, and electronica, all these different kinds of things. The classical music tradition as well, European classical tradition. And all these people will come together to make these records, the Motown records. So there's always been a kind of openness about the genre, you know. People moved really fluidly between them. And there was not a camp kind of thing where, you know, these musicians stick to this. Or it was always, what I grew up understanding was most of those musicians that I was mentored by, like Marcus Belgrave or Donald Walden or Gene Key, they wrote for Stevie Wonder, you know. They were a part of those iconic Motown records we love. So they were doing those records, and so that was a kind of openness that I grew up under, that, you know, good music is good music. We did everything. We played bar mitzvahs. We played in all kinds of different settings. So when I came to New York, I felt like, you know, very comfortable with the idea of moving back and forth between different groups of musicians who some didn't feel the same way I did. But I felt very comfortable about that. Thank you. I'm really excited to be here.
did all of this trouble begin?
Living in America.
Nothing
wrong.
Nothing wrong at all. You're not in any difficulty, but you're out on bond.
No, I'm not.
Have all the charges been dropped?
Yeah, I'm out on love.
Well, are you out on love or out of love? Which is it?
Out on love. Alone from night to night, you find me.
Now, James, this isn't the first time you and your wife have had a problem. Are the two of you going to be able to work this out?
Let's talk about some music.
You want to talk about music and you don't want to talk about what happened?
No, it's all over.
Well, let's talk about your tour. When are you leaving?
We're leaving tomorrow.
And where are you going?
Rio de Janeiro and Sao Paulo, Brazil.
Now, your fans will have read all about this, James. Aren't you concerned about that?
No, Dagestan. I'm concerned because there's nothing wrong.
We'll be right back. think you find out a little bit more about yourself and what it is that you're putting out. It's very difficult for a person to identify exactly what it is about themselves. Well, I think you find out a little bit more about yourself and what it is that you're putting out. It's very difficult for a person to identify exactly what it is about themselves.
I call it Return of the Ankh. It's how Baduism was born. I had my whole life to write Baduism. You know, there was no lifeline, deadline. I had no forever. And I felt like that with this one. I just said what I felt and didn't think about what people would expect or what, even what I expected of myself.